Hello, hello, and this is Notary Life with Kimmi. So today we're going to be discussing pricing. How do we price our general notary jobs? Okay, that is still something that I'm constantly fighting. Am I undercharging, overcharging? I don't think you can really overcharge, but just in case. So let's get right to it though. So it's going to be state specific. What people can charge in California, we may not be able to charge in Georgia. So each state has different rules and regulations as to what you can charge. Let's just start there. But aside from that, what are some different ways that we can make it worth our time where we will enjoy our general notary work and it'll make us motivated to actually go and do it, right? Because no one wants to leave the house for $2. I know I'm not. So anyway, some different terms that you can use for your fees, if allowable by your state, is a convenience fee, a travel fee. And what does that look like? So for me, what I normally do is I have a minimum that I'm not going to leave my house for. So in my general area for one page document, probably like $35 to $40, just minimum. That's like within a 5 mile radius, even less than that. Also, you want to consider the number of people that are signing the documents. If it's one signer, it's going to be different than two. If it's four people, it's going to be more identification required, more time. So I often look at time too. How much do I want to make per hour or every time I leave my home? Okay. And so you're going to look at how many signers you have. You're going to look at what kind of document is it. Is it just a school note or is it a power of attorney or a will or trust documents, which takes way more time? Am I going to a nursing home? Am I going to a hospital? That's going to perhaps require me to pay for parking if I'm going to a hospital. The time that it takes to do the nursing home and hospital jobs can be double just a quick school note, correct? So you want to look at all these different factors when it comes to pricing. So people say, well, Kim, how much do you charge? Let's just tell me how much do you charge? Every single client is going to be different. Now, I have my minimum. I don't have a maximum because it just depends on the factors of the notarization, correct? So when you ask me, just tell me how much, I can't tell you because it might change. And I do have a minimum, like I said, for me in my area, 35. And that's another point also I want you to be aware of. What someone in Atlanta can charge for a document or whatever process it is, I am in a suburb of Atlanta. I may not be able to get that same money that they're requesting. Or if you're in a rural area, you may not even be able to get what I get. So that's why pricing is just so tricky. But have a price list. Think about what you're offering. If it's the weekend, I do not nickel and dime my clients. What do I mean by that? I do not charge them every time I stamp a gold seal. I don't charge them every time I write this down or do that. I don't charge for every single thing. If you want to charge for the processing of your credit card payment, that is something you can think about. I personally don't because it's only like 80 cents or a dollar. Not even normally the process, so I'll just go ahead and factor all of those things into my one flat price. I never want the customer to think, okay, so it's a dollar because you stamped it, it's a dollar for the gold seal, it's $5 for processing the credit card, it's $2 because I gave you cash. You don't want to wear your customer out with fees before you even get started. So for me, I have flat rate pricing. I don't even charge for the stamp. In the state of Georgia, it's $2 right now. At the time of making this video, I don't even usually charge that. I just do a flat rate. So I take all those different questions. Questions equal money, people. Questions equal money. So every time you ask your client a question, the bill is racking up. How many signers? Two. Okay, so now I know I need to identify more people. Oh, you need witnesses. Okay, so I got two signers and two witnesses. Ring, ring, ring. The bill is going up. So again, you don't want to be so high that you end up before your state commission. And you also don't want to be so high that people don't want to use you. You want it to be where they benefit and you benefit. So just be fair with the people as you're doing your pricing. Make it profitable for yourself, make it affordable for them, and they will use you again. They will refer you to their family members, to their coworkers, and they themselves will use you, as I just stated. Also, you don't want to be that notary where it was like, they charged me $100 for one document. Because they will write it on a review. She overcharged me. Or, you know, they didn't think they got the value. So don't make it so high where people will be talking about you in a negative way, but they do recognize that they're getting a mobile service, that you are going to them, and they will pay for that. People understand mobile does cost more overall, no matter what industry you're in. So don't be afraid to price and set a pricing standard that works for you. Again, you want to be motivated to go out. So this is all I have on pricing. I hope this helps you to better understand how to price. This is Notary Life with Kimmi. It's been my pleasure. See you later.